Okay, here's what you need to make a skateboard dolly out of skateboard wheels. You need 8 wheels and bearings. I've pressed these in already. This one I have it pressed in. So, kind of lightly thumb set it. And then I rigged up a little clamp with a 3/8 or 5/8 nut. Make sure that's centered in there. And then just tighten the clamp until the bearings are seated. You have to do this for all 8 wheels so that they'll roll correctly down the rails. So those are all pressed. Eventually these 2-inch by 5/16 bolts are going to go through. There'll be a nut on one side, which actually acts as a washer. This will separate the side of the wheel from the edge of the angle iron, which is angle aluminum. So these go in like this. There'll be 8 of these all together. So there has to be a little space so that the wheel can run free. So I've already pre-drilled these. These are 5/16 holes, and they are exactly 3/4 inch away from the corner. This one's 1 inch in from the end. This one's 1 inch in from the end. These are 12-inch long pieces. On this side, I've gone 3 inches in from each end. That way, when I affix the wheels, they won't hit each other. So that when you look down at like this, you'll see that the wheels will rest on whatever the track is. They won't touch each other. So I'm going to go ahead and tighten up all these bolts. You'll need a couple of crescent wrenches for this. Just kind of snugly tighten them down. Not too tight, because you want that wheel to be able to spin. Once you've completed attaching the wheels to the trucks, these are called trucks, then we need to make the rails. And I've decided to go with rails that are about 8 inches wide, parallel. Gives a lot of stability. Once the completed sled is up on top of there, slides pretty nicely. This is a completed dolly here. Rolls silently and smoothly. This will be a 5-foot rail when I'm done. It's important to make these things parallel so that they can ride smoothly. So that's how these trucks will be in a minute. So these trucks will ride on this pair of rails. And then that'll be centered on there and squared up. Camera rides on this. I've drilled a hole in the bottom of each one. That'll go through the sled. Then the camera rides on top of that. I've got a ball mount for mine and an extender. That looks pretty good. It's not that big a deal because it can freewheel on there. Now I'll take my Sharpie and I'm going to mark on the other side . Attach the trucks, and hopefully everything will look good. So I'm going to measure in. These are 3.5, and so I'll take 3.5 from 12, gives me 8.5. So I need 4.25 in from each end, roughly. So about here. That edge, and about right there. I'll take a screw and fix that to the sled. So I've screwed the, I've attached the sled to the trucks from the other side at the proper distance that I marked with the Sharpie, then that should just sit right on the rails, move silently and freely. And it's okay if these screws stick up a little bit through that wood, because I'm going to put this extender on here and cut that to 12 inches also. That'll cover that, and then the ball mount will sit on top of this. That way you can adjust this and move it around, and so I'll cut this now. Now this one I'm not putting the ball mount on because I don't have one, so I'm just going to put a 1/4-20 bolt through here to attach to the bottom of a camera. Now I'm attaching the adjustable rail to the sled. And this is all ready for a camera. So this will go on the rail, attach the camera, screw the camera on here, put this down, screw this back into the sled. So that'll work. And there's a completed slider. Now I gotta work on the rails. But first, sip. The skateboard slider will only move smoothly if these two copper pipes, which are the rails, are pretty parallel to each other. The way to get that done is to make sure that they are the same distance apart at each end. And so I'm gonna use copper tubing for this, copper pipe, 3/4-inch rigid copper water pipe. I'm gonna cut this 7 inches. I'm gonna put that in between here, and that'll give me a parallel, or give me a rectangle. So I use the tape measure to measure 7 inches on this piece of scrap copper tubing. Mark 7 inches there. Take the pipe cutter, which has a hardened metal edge blade roller on it. The wheel, the sharpened wheel, travels along the edge of the water pipe, and then you just tighten it down a little bit as you go with this knob until it finally breaks. Now you don't want to use a lot of force, just one tiny little turn. Spin this around a couple times, another little turn, spin it around. Keep doing that until the pipe breaks and falls on the floor. You could use a Sawzall, but the cut will be real raggedy. Use a hacksaw, but these tubing cutters are really nice for this. And why not use the right tool? Awesome. Why not use the right tool, right? And it ends up being a parallel, these two cuts are parallel to each other, which is great. All right, so I use these T-joints. Put this pipe in here if it'll go, otherwise I might have to deburr it a little bit. That worked pretty well. Put this on the other end. So I just gotta make sure these two are facing the same way, which they're pretty close. And put it on the end of the track. And these two rails are parallel pretty much at this end. I need to do it at the other end also, and then I'll have a parallel track that's very portable. So the rails are complete, the sled, the trucks, everything's good to go. Drives very smoothly. These are 5-foot rails. I also have 10 footers. See how crooked my basement floor is. And there you go. Just clean up your mess, you're all done.